Welcome back to another episode of the Switch Survival Guide. This is part two of our series where we are building this crazy floating fortress, which will be a real game changer for you. This fortress will be almost invincible to nearly any dinosaur's attacks, and it will allow you to bring all of your dinosaurs, supplies, and actually your entire base with you anywhere on the island that has a body of water attached to it, which means you can go just about anywhere and bring your house with you, which will be very helpful throughout the rest of the game. So on the last episode, we built the foundation for this base, and today we are going to build the walls, gateways, ladders, and courtyard, and pretty much everything else for the rest of the structure of this entire base. So watch the rest of this episode, and we'll show you how to make this base into an awesome fortress. Now on the last episode, we built this stone foundation platform for our raft base, and we made it 6 foundations long by 5 foundations wide, and that is going to serve as the base for everything that we do today. So if you missed that episode, definitely go back and watch the episode right before this, and you'll see how to do everything here step by step. And this armored raft foundation will actually protect the raft itself and make it invulnerable to nearly everything but alpha predators and whales, and pretty soon we'll teach you how to defend against even those. So go back and watch that if you missed it, and we will start building today using this as our main base and build up from there. So we are back and we grabbed some more supplies, and now it is actually time to build some of the walls and door frames of this base so we can get the basic structure going. And as you can see, there's a lot of flashing and snapping going on, but I want to get this to snap to the higher platform there, and I'm starting with a solid wall in front of the rudder because the rudder can actually get damaged by some things like a T-Rex if there's a door frame in front of it. But as long as it has a solid wall in front of it, it's going to be just fine and it will be impervious to damage. And then I'm putting door frames next to these walls so that I can easily access the front and back of my base. Now, when I'm placing these, you'll notice it's flashing between a brighter green and a more blue-green color, and I can hit the X button to switch it. That means the lighter blue there is facing outward, and the brighter green means it's facing inward. And I want all of my walls and doors facing outward from here so that the base looks good. It's just more of an aesthetic thing. So I'm going to put a door frame in the very middle of this platform here, because I want a back door right in the middle, and I'm going to just continue extending walls around that, and that's going to be the basic shape of the back of our base. So now comes the really tricky part. We are going to put down some stone dinosaur gateways, and unlike everything else that snaps to a certain spot on the foundation, these actually just lay down on top. So I'm going to start by placing this thatch doorway as a place marker so I can see how thick this area is and line up this stone dinosaur gateway. Now, dino gateways are really tricky because they can go at any spot, they don't snap for you. And I'm going to run this in fast forward because it really took me a long time to position this correctly. It's also important to note that you actually place them from the inside of your base facing outward. And as you can see there, that's sticking out just a little further than I like, and I'm kind of a perfectionist with this kind of thing, so I'm just going to keep lining this up until I get it to where I really like it. And we're also going to check the right and left hand sides to make sure that there's no gaps in the wall each time I place one down. So it looks like everything lines up nicely on the left and right hand sides. And I'm going to look at the front again, and it looks like that's a pretty good fit right there too. Also, be careful of sharks when you're jumping in the water. So I place that from the inside facing out, because when I actually put a door on there, then I want that to be facing outwards, and I want the door to open outwards. So I've noticed most of the time if you place it from the inside facing out, the door will open outwards just like you want it to. So that's actually a perfect position for that, and now I can demolish this thatched door frame, and that is out of the way. And we have another perfect 2 foundation wide gap for this next dinosaur gateway, And I'm going to be positioning that slowly, and we will fast forward again just to make sure everything gets snapped properly there. And you can kind of see, if you look really closely on the bottom, you can sort of see where it clips into the other objects, and we want it to just very slightly clip into the wall and the other dinosaur gateway. And that gives us a perfect wall there. And the reason we're using these, aside from the fact that it makes the inside of our base really spacious and able to open up really wide, so we can even park dinosaurs inside our base if we need to, but it also only uses two objects or two structures per dinosaur gate. So we get this really big, two wide and two high, which is four structure sized wall. And it only costs us two structures. So even though it's more resource intensive, it frees up our build so that we have more structures available to place. And once again, if you have increased the structure limit on the platform through your settings, then you don't have to worry so much about limiting the amount of structures on your raft. But if you're playing on official or online, then you definitely want to conserve every structure you possibly can. So I'm just going to be real nitpicky about these, try to make sure there's no gaps between them. And you'll want to be a little bit less careful. You know, if it's not perfect, you might want to leave it, because if you don't have the ability to pick it back up with that update, then you'll be losing all the materials for that stone gate. So don't be too picky if you have to sacrifice a ton of materials. So I think that's going to have us in pretty good shape. Those two gateways look pretty darn good there. And I'll go ahead and apply the gate itself, and we actually have a really nice enclosed wall on either side, and that's going to keep us very safe on the sides of this raft. So check that out. We can open up the whole base to make it really wide open and spacious when we're home on Herbivore Island, or we can close it all up to be an impervious fortress when we're out in exploring the rest of the island. So we'll go ahead and add the courtyard next. So now that we have the main base accounted for, we're actually going to add the walls for the courtyard, and I'm going to line myself up with the center of the raft, which is the rudder there, and I will start with adding a doorway on the front, because I want to have a front door that I can use to escape the courtyard if I get a large predator to chase me into it. And we'll just go ahead and add some walls up the front so it'll be nice and secure. And we now have a two foundation wide courtyard, which will serve as a perfect guideline for adding some stone dinosaur gateways. So we've gotten pretty good at this, we got plenty of practice, and we'll go ahead and add this next one using the walls as a template to line that up properly. And that actually looks like we got it pretty good the first try. And then we will go ahead and line up this next one. And by the time we're done, we have a set of stone dinosaur gateways, which will be six foundations long, and they're like five foundations high. I mean, it's pretty high up. So the sides of this raft will be just practically invincible from just about anything other than alpha predators. So it's going to be a very secure raft with a whole lot of room. And now we've got all of the base walls down, and we just need to build up from there. So we'll be right back with some more supplies. And we're back with some stone walls, and we're going to go ahead and extend all of these stone walls to be two stories high. This will give us a lot of room to build inside our base, and it will actually be big enough that a lot of dinosaurs can even come into the base, as long as you're really careful not to hop on their saddle. If you do that, you'll get stuck in the ceiling. It's not pretty, trust me. So we're going to make these walls two stories high, which should be enough to protect us even from a tyrannosaur. I've heard stories of Rexes glitching over a two-story high wall, but in general you'll be pretty safe from them. And we now have this cool courtyard, which we can use to lure a predator to come into the gates and then slam it shut in order to keep it inside. So it's a very effective way to tame things. So now we're back with the ceilings that we need to give us the roof for our main base. And I'm actually going to start snapping them from the wall that is right above the rudder, because everything we build, we're building straight out from the rudder, and we're trying to snap these effectively to each other. Now, ceilings can get a little bit glitchy, so we're just going to continue back from that front ceiling, And as you can see here, the ceiling's kind of bouncing between the snap points, between the wall and the ceiling we've been making. So I'm going to try and fail to get that to snap to the ceiling itself so that the gap is actually in the very back of the raft. And that should keep us pretty safe because there's not much that's going to be coming and attacking the backside of our raft once we're through with it. And it's a tiny little crack. It's not 100% perfect. You get some glitching issues sometimes using these raft foundations, but it's pretty close. And these ceilings will actually snap through the Stinosaur gateways, so it gives you a really nice closed-off ceiling. And the roof will also be really handy because we can grow a garden on top of it and grow our own vegetables while we're doing all of this, and we'll just take our garden with us everywhere we go, which will be very handy. We'll get into gardening pretty soon, too. I'm leaving a gap in the ceiling because I want to make a stone hatch frame, and that will allow us to have a little trap door that we can actually climb up to the roof from inside the base. And I always like to have a route to get to the top from the inside, so if you're attacked by something on the outside, you don't have to step outside where it's really dangerous in order to get to the roof. And the roof is going to be the main place we'll do our fighting from, because we can shoot down from the roof and hit stuff without it being able to hurt us. So now we've got the ceiling in place, and we have a stone hatch frame there, which will let us put a ladder down. So we'll be right back with some more supplies. So we're going to need our Pteranodon for this next bit, and it's a good idea to set him on his own ordering group so that you can whistle to him if you fall off the roof and you can have him come pick you up. So I'm going to add some ladders going down from the roof, and whenever you're making ladders, it's always a good idea to start them from the top and build down, because that makes sure they clip correctly to the ceiling you're building down from. Because if they don't, you may have a big ladder and you're not actually able to climb over the top. It gets really finicky and glitchy. But this seems to be working fine, and the ladder's letting me climb up and down even though it's partially embedded in the wall. Clipping gets a little weird with rafts sometimes, and the snap points can just get a little wonky. But we don't need to build it all the way to the floor. As long as we can reach it from our normal standing height, we're fine. So when you're doing a stone hatch frame like this, you always want to add the trapdoor before you add the ladder, because if I were to snap a ladder onto the space where the trapdoor is, you cannot control which direction that trapdoor is going to open when it actually gets placed in there. So it may actually render your ladder useless if it goes in the wrong space, and then you have to make your ladder again. So I'm going to try to climb on this thing and make sure this is placed in the correct position, because, you know, once again, it's a little awkward, and it's kind of hard to climb in and out of a hatch frame sometimes, but I'm trying to select this from the ceiling just so I don't get stuck on the ground. Okay, so let's try this. And that looks like it works just fine. We're able to climb up and down the ladder, and it's close enough to the ceiling we can actually open that hatch frame from the ground. So it looks like our ladders are in great shape. So now that the main base is finished, we're just going to add a few extra finishing touches, like doors in the door frames. So we'll go ahead and add doors in all of the door frames, and that's going to give us good access to the front and back of this raft. And now everything is totally enclosed here. And what in the world? Oh, looks like a parasaur is trying to get out of our raft. And all of the parasaurs are now freaking out. This is why you do not attack herbivores on Herbivore Island if they can do any damage to you, because everyone in their entire species, which is all over the island, will start attacking you. And if I punched a trike, all of my other trikes would come and attack all of my other dinos. So we are back, and I'm going to add some ramps so we can have easy access on and off of our base. Now where I'm standing right now, I'm planning to add some storage boxes so that when I go and gather things, my gathering dinos can just come right up to this ramp and start unloading supplies right through that door, and that'll be really easy for them. So I do want a ramp on this side. And I'm also adding another couple ramps in front of the taming pen so I can get a wild dino to chase me up this ramp into the taming pen, and then I'll duck into my base and they'll be trapped inside. I also want to get some ramps going up the front door here so I have easy access from the front of my raft in case I ever need to make a quick dash inside from that side. So we're also going to head on over here and make a nice ramp in the back door for the same reason. So now we'll have easy access to every door on the right, left, front, and back of the raft, and I'm sure there will be times where something chases us and we need to have a very quick entrance. So we'll add two more ramps on the left-hand side too, so depending on where we park, we can get a dino to chase us onto this side. And also, if we end up getting close to our structure limit, we can remove some ramps that are not 100% necessary and be able to add some more stuff to our raft later on. So that pretty much completes our raft, and I'm going to close up all of these doors so we can get a good feel for how this raft looks when it's totally shut in. And as you can see, we have a very spacious living area here. We've got enough room to really spread out and put some really large structures. We can also technically build a second floor there. And we have our taming pen, which will be really helpful, and we can also put our dinosaurs in there when we're not taming things. I'm also going to head on up this ladder, and we have a quick, easy access to the roof, which will be a good place to park flying dinosaurs, and we can grow a garden on top, which will give us food and narco berries and all that good stuff. And this entire fortress can come with us anywhere we go on any expedition. And the only problem is we don't have any way to attack other dinosaurs easily from the base yet. So in the next episode, we're actually going to add some defenses to this base. And if you've never heard of Plant Species X, it is an amazing biological turret. It's a plant that shoots explosive poison seeds at dinosaurs, which slows them down to a crawl. And I am going to go on a really dangerous expedition to see if I can find some Plant Species X seeds. And now that I have unlocked the large crop plots, I can actually create these turrets around my base, and those will protect this base from even things like alpha predators and whales. If you have a couple of turrets on the back of your raft that shoot Plant Species X seeds, they can actually keep a whale so slow it cannot damage your raft at all. So that's how we're going to counter whales using this raft. So be sure to watch the next episode, and that will be incredibly helpful to teach you how to find and get Plant Species X seeds, and then we'll teach you how to farm and grow Plant Species X turrets really soon. So thanks so much for watching. I hope this was helpful. If it was, please like this video and subscribe to our channel, and be sure your notifications are turned on so it will notify you when we launch the next video in this series, and we'll show you how to make this raft completely invincible. Thanks so much for watching. Thanks so much for watching this video from the Ark Survival Guide. If you enjoyed it or found it helpful, please like this video and subscribe to our channel so we can bring you more great guides like this one. Ark is an amazing game, but there is so much to learn before you can really enjoy it. We are dedicated to bringing you high-quality guides, tutorials, and Let's Play videos that are fun, helpful, clean, and suitable for the entire family. There's a tutorial in this series for everything we have done so far in this video. Check out these playlists for more episodes from this series and other guides to help you enjoy your journey on Ark.